Thank you, Jeff. Thank you. Thank you. All right.
I was riding down Swamp Road, smelling the early morning dew off of the vegetables. You brought me back, Sherman.
You're welcome, Barry. You're welcome.
Thank you. What a great collection of little vignettes and character sketches you put together. I really appreciated how you gave us a picture of growing up in farmland in Utah. I always like to frame evaluations in terms of what you did really well and what it would take for your speech to be a championship winning speech, because I'm ambitious. What you did really well is continue to engage your audience with your demeanor. You're just really easygoing and you're able to connect with people. And you make great eye contact, and you're not like really tense and making people feel uncomfortable, so which is great. So you have a great presence in the room, and you have great vocal projection. It's easy to hear you. It's not easy. It is easy to pay attention, and we never get distracted from you because you're always engaging and focused. I always like your elocution because you pronounce things very well, and you never make any errors in terms of ahs and ums and stutters or anything like that. You're very smooth. And you also are really great at telling your story and setting a mood and painting a picture for us. I likened in your manual in my comments that your story was like this mosaic, like a quilt. And we saw these little patchworks, and then only at the end did you zoom out, and we were like, oh, a quilt! And kind of got the whole picture of how it all fit together. So I liked how you did that. In terms of things that you could do to make this a championship speech, work on when you move, move with purpose. So if you talk about Grandpa's pig, you might bend down and, you know, move with purpose, so that your points are accentuated with some sort of movement that connects the idea together. The other is, consider in your development or your structure, perhaps focusing on one or three stories that maybe fit together. My problem was that there were so many that the only one that I really remembered was your grandfather at the end, because that was the main attention that my mind went to in the cheapskateness of his life. So maybe consider that, focusing on just a couple of stories that you could go a little deeper in. And finally, how is it that you can connect yourself into these stories? I heard a lot about the other people, but I wanted to hear about you, and I wanted to hear about your experience and how all of these people impacted you and transformed your life so that I would be challenged as well. There you have it. Nice job. Thank you. All right.